Mr. President, what about the pay freezes that you apparently have decided on?
No question.
Well, since everyone else has reported it, Mr. Regan said so, Mr. Weinberger.
Maybe you'd just like to talk then. Maybe you'd just like to talk.
Today?
No, I don't think so. Good.
Say anything now. I've got to look at that schedule again. The pencil changes in my schedule.
Should I look at the camera?
Yeah. At least for a while.
The postmaster of the house. We have the same hobby, riding horses. I love riding horses.
Well,
I raise rabies.
Oh, I've got two Arabians.
I read that article about the one you got from Mexico.
No, that's an Anglo Arab. That's a cross between a thoroughbred and an Arabian.
That's what I want.
How do you do? Tell us. Manager of the cloakroom.
Well, nice to see you, and congratulations to all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. And thank you all very much for the help that I know you and the staff.
This is real large place, huh?
Yes, actually.
It's smaller, I just think, than when you see it.
You know that this morning, just this morning, Secretary General of the United Nations sat over there in that chair, came in for a meeting. He'd never been here before and said the same thing.
Yeah, there's something about it. All that stuff is awesome, you know. The person who designed this room, he had an idea what the job is. There's something to it.
You mentioned horses. Warner Annenberg won't be this. Stay here, this and these. Mm-hmm. This is a collection by an artist that in bronze has done literally the history of the Western sound.
Do you follow the bronze?
No, I don't think I have.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's really detailed. And, that takes a lot of work.
Yeah.
To get a guy hitting the ball and to do a statue like that, I can't imagine doing it.
Yeah. That's the Remington over there.
I'll let you bring one of the horses right up here rather than have to go out there. He
did keep one.
Did he? Well, in tradition.
Not the difference in those days. My goodness, the world has deteriorated. I've got a picture of it.
That's when we were working on it. We'll take it when you scream right at the door.
American cavalry saber.
No, they misinterpreted it. They want to cut that out of your budget.
Pretty nice horse.
What?
The Anglo Arab.
Yes, yeah. But you know, a thing about his training, we've got a cure to this now. But that they evidently do just for the monster effect was when you take him out of the stall when we first got him, he'd come out on his hind legs. You're holding him on, he's up there pawing and so forth.
My stud does that.
Well, and you know the whole thing, I found out there's an Arab breeder in longtime friend of ours in Arizona who has a man working for him who's working for the president. The time he had this horse.
Chauncey?
Tom Chauncey.
He has some beautiful horses. Yeah. I had one in his mare.
This man told him that this was trained for that, so that then everybody's saying, he's going to ride that horse. And you know what the funny thing was? Get the saddle on him, get on him, he's a fine ride.
There's a little politics in that too, you know, that's how they do it in the politics.
Tom Chauncey has some beautiful horses. I had a mare from you.
Are you ready for him now, sir?
Yes.
Mr. President,
good to see you.
Hi, good to see you.
See you again.
Mr. President, good to see you.
How are you, Mr. President? Pleased to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, was
good.
David K. Mr. President,
nice to meet you.
Henry Gandy, President of the Board, Mr. President. Mr. President, Mike Johnson.
Thank you for taking the time to do this.
Pleased to do it.
Thank you.
Mr. President, it's a great honor, sir. My honor. Mr. President, thank you very much.
Mr. President,
how are you? Just fine.
Jim Hall.
Hello, Mr. President.
Here's the most, this is the most trouble.
Philly Fitz.
Mr. President, good to see you. I'd love for you to autograph this that we used at the convention. Everyone else, your vice president, everyone else has done me the honor, and if you would.
Why don't we get that right after
the interposal?
Yeah. Always prepared. Thank you, sir.
Most insurance salesmen are.
Mr. President, thank you for the birthday present.
This is Ernest Beeman's birthday.
Good job, Rick.
Well, happy birthday.
Cameroon.
Please meet you, Mr. President.
Hello, Ken. How are you?
All right.
Good. Okay.
Mr. President, how are you? Good to see you again.
Good to see you, sir.
Good to see you.
Mr. President, my pleasure. My pleasure. Thank you, sir.
Tommy Anderson.
Nice to see you. You're responsible for me losing a white suit one time. Well, I was running off some announcements for your campaign in 76 and it got ink all over my suit right in the home suit. I just wanted you to know that.
The only other white suit I ever ruined, I knew you couldn't be that old. Back in the early 30s, I guess I shouldn't confess to this, when I was a sports announcer out in Iowa. And Iowa, you know, was famous for, in those Prohibition days, for its roadhouses that served Iowa champagne, which was M.K. Goetz near beer, spiked with alcohol. And a group of us in this place one night after my sports summary, and I was in, or no, I wasn't, Zutz Schammel, All-American tackle for Iowa, was there. I'd played guard in football, and we were talking football. And there was some fella in a white suit. He'd have him both the way you dream about doing in the game, shoulder to shoulder, right at above the thighs, hung him over our back, and kept right on going and dumped him over a barbed wire fence into a plowed field. And then that was that, the white suit.
Right.
Listen, kid. Can we get a group shot, or are there too many?
Thank you.
You're good.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Listen, I should be thanking you, and I do thank you for all the help that you give our people and give me. I'm very grateful.
We tolerate them.
Yeah.
Spoken like a true press secretary.